Good morning, students. Today we shall read the poem, The Last Bargain. It's the fourth poem from the book Honeydew. The Last Bargain is a poem written by the famous and renowned Bengali poet Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was born in Calcutta, now Kolkata, on 6th of May 1861. He received his education at his own home and later at University College, London. He was a poet, dramatist, novelist, short story writer, a philosopher, and a nation builder. He is the composer of India's national anthem, Jan Gana Mana. He founded a school at Shanti Niketan in West Bengal, which later known as Vishwabharati, that is International University. He received the Nobel Prize for Gitanjali, which is a collection of poems. He died in Calcutta on 7th of August 1941. So, the poem is about a person looking for a job. The speaker in the poem wants to have such a job in which he doesn't want to lose his freedom. He receives the first proposal from the king. The king offers him power in turn for his labor or hard work. But he refuses the offer from the king. The poem conveys a strong message that money make us happy, but simplicity and innocence are the most supreme of all. To know more about the poem, let's begin the explanation of the poem, The Last Bargain, by Rabindranath Tagore. It's a poem of 16 lines composed in blank verse, means it does not have any particular rhyme scheme. So let's begin the explanation of the poem, The Last Bargain. Come and hire me, I cried while in the morning I was walking on the stone-paved road. Sword in hand, the king came in his chariot. He held my hand and said, I will hire you with my power. But his power counted for naught, and he went away in his chariot. See the meaning of difficult words. Hire means to have the use of something for a short time by paying for it. Stone pave means metal road. Chariot means an open vehicle or carriage with two wheels drawn by horses. So in this stanza, the speaker says that one day while he was walking on the stone-paved road, in the morning, the king came in his chariot with a sword in his hand. Seeing him, the speaker pleads the king to hire him. Note that it is the morning time that symbolizes hope and courage. Hence, the poet seems to be hopeful. Stone-paved road. Here means a difficult path. King in his chariot with a sword means a person with power. The speaker pleads to the king, which means that he is in need of something badly. He asks the king to hire him. Hire here means that the poet wants to get what the king has. The king holds the hand of the speaker and says that he will hire him with his power. However, power seems to be naught, that is nothing or worthless to the speaker because it is not everlasting. The king will die and so his powers. The speaker is thus not satisfied with what the king offered him. He rejects the offer and the king goes away in his chariot. So in this stanza, the speaker describes his first struggle to get something that fails. Now the stanza 2. In the heat of the midday, the houses stood with shut doors. I wandered along the crooked lane. An old man came out with his bag of gold. He pondered and said, I will hire you with my money. He weighed his coins one by one, but I turned away. See the meaning? Naut means nothing, the number zero. Pondered means thought deeply. Weighed means to measure how heavy something is. Now, it is the daytime and very hot outside. The doors of houses are closed. The speaker is wandering along the crooked lane. Crooked lane means bent or uneven road. Thus, like the stone-paved road of the stanza, this road is also difficult and full of troubles. Soon, an old man comes out of his house along with a bag of gold, that is huge wealth. He pondered that is thought carefully and finding that the speaker is in need of something. He offers him money and says that the old man will hire him with that. Okay. The old man, in order to show how wealthy, he starts counting his gold coins one by one. However, like the power of king, the wealth of old man seems to be worthless because it could not make the old man young again, nor it could make the climate cool. The speaker understands that wealth is not something which he needs because, like the power, it doesn't remain in one hand forever. He wants something else and thus goes away from there. It was evening, the garden hedge was all aflower. The fair maid came out and said, "I will hire you," with a smile. Her smile paled and melted into tears, and she went back alone into the dark. See the meaning? Hedge, a row of bushes. Paled means when a person's face loses its natural color, it becomes pale. Glisten means to shine by reflecting light. Now, in this stanza, it is evening time, and the garden hedge means fence or boundary of the garden is aflower. Aflower means blooming with flowers. Okay. In other words, the garden is looking very beautiful and romantic. A fair maid, beautiful girl, comes out and says that she wants to hire the speaker with a smile, that is, with her beauty. However, the speaker finds that, like the king's power and old man's wealth, her beauty is also not everlasting. Soon the smile of that beautiful lady is paled and melted with tears, means gone, and she goes back along into the dark. Dark here symbolizes hopelessness, and the speaker don't want any hopelessness. Understand? The speaker understands that a smile that made her look beautiful is fake, is false, and not everlasting. It has hidden sorrows of the lady. The day is over, but the speaker fails to make a bargain. However, he has patience and persistence. He doesn't give up. The sun glistened on the sand and the sea waves broke waywardly. A child sat playing with shells. He raised his head and seemed to know me and said, "I hire you with nothing." From henceforward, that bargain struck in child's play made me a free man. See the meaning? Waywardly means change of behavior that is difficult to control. Shells means a hard covering that protects eggs, nuts, etc. And henceforward means from this time on. Now, in this stanza, in final stanza, the new day comes with new hope and courage for the speaker. He's at the seashore and sees the sun glistening, means shining, on the sand, and the sea waves breaking waywardly, means sea waves are striking the shore in an unpredictable way. This scene is presented by the speaker, symbolizes his love and appreciation for nature. Soon the speaker finds a child sitting on the seashore and playing with shells. So this is symbolical image. Okay. As the child has no desire for power or wealth or beauty, he is free of all these things which make the man a servant. What makes a man servant? Power, beauty, and wealth. Understand? The child raises his head and sees the speaker. It looks to the speaker that the child knows him. Okay, seeing the speaker in a quest means search for something, the child offers to hire him with nothing. Nothing is a profound symbol here. It means freedom, liberty, independence, and free from any desire. The speaker understands that this is what he was longing for since long. He accepts the child's offer, and from thenceforward, means from that day, the speaker finds freedom in the child's play and thus becomes a free man. This was the ultimate destination of the speaker. So that's all about the poem, The Last Bargain. Now let's discuss poetic devices in the poem, The Last Bargain. There is symbolism in the poem. Symbolism means an object or idea or a person, means something deep and not what the word means. Understand? Like stone paved road. See the second line of the stanza, stone paved road. And the crooked lane of second stanza, second line, crooked lane, symbolize hard and difficult path. Okay, the poet was traveling on. Similarly, see, king in his chariot in the first stanza, with sword in his hand, symbolizes epitome of power. An old man with a bag of gold in second stanza symbolizes wealth, and a lady with a smile. See the third stanza, symbolizes beauty. In addition, the morning symbolizes hope and courage, while the evening and dark symbolizes hopelessness. Okay. Do you understand? Morning symbolizes hope and courage, while the evening and dark symbolizes hopelessness. The another poetic device used in the poem is alliteration. Okay. What is alliteration? It is the repetition of consonant sound in a line. Example, see, I was walking. You can see second line, I was walking. So here W sound is repeated. I was walking. W sound in was, and then W sound in were sound. We will not say W, we will say were sound. I was walking. Were sound in was, and then again were sound in walking. Repeated. Then next, the king came. In this phrase, ka sound is repeated. Ka sound in came and ka sound in came. Next, the sun glistened on the sand. See the last stanza. Here, sa sound is repeated. Okay. And sea waves made me free man. See. And sea waves. Glisten on the sand and the sea waves. Here sound is repeated. And then at last, made me free man. Ma sound is repeated in made. Then in me, ma, and then man. Ma sound is repeated. So thus, there is a perfect use of alliteration in the poem. So that's all about the poem, The Last Bargain. Thank you so much.